Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of this Finnish Let's Play. Like I promised in the last episode, we are going to attack the Soviet Union in this new episode. So after we prepare our paratroopers to deal with the Comintern miners, and at least most of these divisions are ready, which shouldn't take long, we will attack the Soviet Union. So let's continue with the preparation. Alright, these paratroopers are here to attack the capital of Mongolia. I need to pick up these guys. By the way, before starting these episodes, I decided to set up another convoy to this province here. I decided after all that I needed supplies to be delivered to Hong Kong and Guangzhou after all. I also set up several convoys along the path, the supply path that the system uses, supply system uses to supply my troops here. As we can see, we have several ports along these routes. So I decided to take advantage of that and created several convoys, including here, here and here. I've also set up a convoy to Narva. So that's all that I did. Okay, I have a convoy coming here, doesn't make sense. It's a leftover from previous episodes. This doesn't make sense also. This is in Africa, I believe. Yeah, gonna cancel it then. They're routing supplies to a zone that I don't need it. Need them. So, let's continue. Still need organization to be able to board the planes. Great, more supply planes. By the way, we are wasting lots of IC. I'm going to build more supply planes. Don't care. I have lots of manpower and lots of IC. These planes will be needed for sure. Well, our navy has arrived at inner Gulf of Finland. So we have to wait, not much though. This looks like an island. No, sorry, it's not an island. We have to wait, speed this up a bit, not too much though. Interception tactics, great. Finally, our interception tactics are up to date. More leadership for officers. One more armor division, I'm gonna deploy it here. I will have to build our order of battle very, very soon. Let's see if these paratroopers can board the planes. Yeah, good. Okay, I'm going to divide these. Okay, two divisions for each target should be enough, hopefully. We'll keep waiting. I'm essentially waiting for the tanks. Okay, more divisions, gonna send this one here. I want these guys to be able to break through with ease. These supply planes will prove invaluable. I'm pretty sure of it. The supply situation is good here. Over here it's enough. Same thing here. Okay, in the paratroopers front everything is ready. The navy is ready. Just need these last divisions and I will build a hoop. A few days later I will declare war on the Soviets. So our first technology from 1938 is research, great. Our troops will start upgrading right now. More supply planes. I call them supply planes, but they are transport planes that will be used in supply in our troops. Small arms advance, great. This will compensate for the lack of artillery, lack of support, so our troops will have marines and mountain troops will have better weapons, heavy time weapons that will compensate a bit for the lack of support brigades, for the lack of artillery for example. My situation here is not... it's not wonderful. So I'll keep these divisions in range of our supply planes. I could make an air bridge, but I believe that the Soviets, with the help of our spies, will be defeated very soon after after they lose Moscow. They will surrender, I'm sure of it. Moscow, Leningrad and Stalingrad, once they're captured, they are a huge blow for the Soviet national unity. Moscow alone is worth 30 VPs. Okay, one more division. This guy is going here. And I was forgetting to say that they have lots of coastal VPs, that I'll be taking them with our navy. Like this one, this one, no, this one not. Don't know if I can reach there. Odessa will probably be captured by the time my navy reaches it, so let's continue. Last fighters. Not the last, but one of the last. Yeah, still have a few of them that will be reserves. Okay, couple of days more and I'm going to finish this UB. Let me see the range of these planes. Yeah, they can reach here, not more. Gonna build more supply. Okay, I think I have enough supply planes. The Russians won't last that long. It'll last maybe 4 months, 5 at tops, unless I'm severely mistaken. They will be defeated before the end of the year. More divisions. Okay, goes there. Okay, after these ones are ready, I'm gonna build the hub and attack them. Soviets. The last technologies of 38, infantry technologies. Everything to officers and spies. Finally, the Soviets are starting to kill, to mass murder my spies. Two leaderships that suffice for that war. Well, these guys here have lots of supplies. We have, because of the port, so I'm going to put these divisions here. I just want these guys to be able to advance, since they have ports. They won't have as many supplies problems as my center. As soon as I build the loop, the supply demands will be lower, which is actually great that we haven't built the loop yet, because these guys will have much more supplies in the area that they actually need. So it's time to build that hub. Okay, I'm gonna wait just more 2 or 3 days. I will attack in September 1 no matter what. Probably it's already very late. Time to build a loop then. Okay, I'm going to disband all headquarters. This facilitates my life. So reception is hard the higher headquarters. Okay, I'm actually going to start from here. was a mistake. Another one. Okay, our second army, another army group. I'm gonna attach this army group to the this headquarter. Another mistake. I'm going to create an army here. But I won't assign any leaders. This is just for organization, for not seeing troops without headquarters. That clutters this guy UI whatever. So let's continue building the hub here. Damn it, made another mistake. Taking a lot of time. Oh well. Damn it. It's better to start over and then deal with this mess. Sorry guys, the action will start really soon, but I have to finish this. Doing this as fast as I can. It's almost over, almost done. Thankfully. Okay, it's time to create the armies. I don't believe it, it's almost ready. Our time is already up, so I will extend this episode to be able to keep up with my promise to start a war in this episode. Well, forgot about that guy, no problem. Okay, let me see, the 8th army is full, so this will eventually be needed for another army, so another army will eventually be needed, so no harm done. And we are almost ready for war. Just have to check. This guy goes under the command of Supreme Headquarters. I just have to check the area. Yeah, it's okay. Everything okay here. Finland's headquarters area. It's also okay. Yeah. Let me check the Asia headquarters. It was not okay. So just need to assign the officers and we are ready for war with the Soviets. Okay, this is already assigned. Okay, this guy was here. Another highly skilled leader will command this army group. Now for the armies. This guy is always here, only one at quarter. As long as I have logistic wizards, which are very few, I will assign them to army group, to armies. Because they are very low skilled. Okay, no more logistic wizards. We are done with the European, with the Soviet theater headquarter. Time to this one. Here I'm going to assign a battle master. Let me see if there are any engineers. Yeah, we have one here. So this guy goes here. Bad choice. Okay, I have several six skill leaders, so I'm going to assign them to the army group. This guy goes to the army. No more engineers. So this guy. Okay, I'm going to assign at least, I will try, I'm not sure if I have enough leaders for that, at least one leader for per province. Better start doing it from here. This is important because the presence of a leader, of a general, is very important at each battle because of the tactics. The chances of choosing good tactics and counter tactics, it's higher if a leader is present. If you have no leader, you will be in serious disadvantage. So at least one leader per province, if we can do that, not sure. Yeah, I knew it. Not enough leaders. Well. Okay, we are now ready for war, just one more, a few more days for the headquarters to reinforce, and these guys that are assigned leaders to regain organization. By 1 of September should also, everything should be okay. Okay, let's see. Yeah, they've regained most of the organization. So, time for war. We are now at war with the Comintern. Well guys, sorry for the cliffhanger, but this episode is already very long. I hope you have enjoyed it, and we'll deal with the Soviets in the next one. Take care.